Hello dear students, today again welcome. Today we will be dealing with one of the very important topic, that is note making. This is one form of written communication from Department of English, from New English High School and Junior College. We will have an introduction about note making. What actually is note making? The topic here from 3.2. Note making is an involved activity. It is a focused writing skill in note taking. The students usually pick out the central idea on contents, all the primary, secondary, and tertiary data using a suitable method of condensed representation like a point, a tree diagram, or a table. Normally in note making and note taking, note making is what, where we take out some of the points and from that points we have to make a tree diagram. Let's find out some of the icebreaker. We have to complete the web. We take notes of, generally what we take notes of, one is of, if someone is giving a speech, we generally take a some of the points in our notebook. That is, we take a notes of speech. Another is article, book, and another is lecture. Another icebreaker for you, discuss in a group why you take notes. Yeah, why we generally take notes? Obviously, it is for taking out some of the important points, to jot down the dates, or to remember the things minutely. So that is the main purpose we take the notes. Here are some of the points why we take the notes. First is, improvement in listening becomes an active process, reduce study time and very helpful during revision, help in presenting impressive assignment quickly, leads to better academic performance overall. We can say over here, ज्यांना आपली लिस्निंग कॅपॅसिटी वाढवायची असते, एक ॲक्टिव्ह प्रोसेस म्हणजे पटकन पटकन जेव्हा कोणी बोलत असेल तेव्हा ते नोट डाऊन करत जातात काही पॉईंट्स. रिड्यूस स्टडी टाईम, जनरली बऱ्याच मुलांना सवय असते की अगर आपला आन्सर आहे, पॅरेग्राफ आहे, इवन पॅरेंट्स त्यांच्या मुलांना शिकवतात, तर त्या पॅरेग्राफचे काही इम्पॉर्टंट पॉईंट्स तुम्ही शेजारी लिहायचे किंवा एक हायलाईट करून ठेवायचे. त्याने पण वी कॅन से की नाही का, आपले एक छोटे छोटे 1, 2, 3, 4 पर्टिक्युलर आन्सरमधले शॉर्ट पॉईंट्स घेतले की वी कॅन एलॉबरेट दॅट आन्सर. नेक्स्ट इज, हेल्प इन प्रेझेंटिंग इम्प्रेसिव्ह असाइनमेंट क्विकली. अगर नोट्स बनवल्या छोटी छोटी आणि आपल्याला सांगितलं की प्रेझेंटेशन बनवायचं आहे, तर डेफिनेटली आपण शॉर्ट नोटपासून एक मोठा छानपैकी प्रेझेंटेशन बनवू शकतो. लीड्स टू बेटर अकॅडमिक परफॉर्मन्स ओवरऑल. अगर तुम्ही तुमचा अभ्यास अकॅडमिक इयरचा असं नोट्स काढून, पॉईंट्स काढून केला, तर डेफिनेटली तुम्हाला तुमचा अभ्यास छानपणे लक्षात राहतो. या, व्हॉट इज नोट टेकिंग अँड नोट मेकिंग? बोथ द स्किल्स आर टोटली डिफरंट. लेट्स विल सी फर्स्ट व्हॉट इज नोट टेकिंग. नोट टेकिंग इज अ पॅसिव प्रोसेस विच इज अंडरटेकन ड्यूरिंग लेक्चर. नोट टेकिंग काय आहे? जेव्हा लेक्चर चालू असतं, तुमचे शिक्षक तुम्हाला जेव्हा लेक्चर देत असतात पर्टिक्युलर टॉपिकबद्दल, तेव्हा आपण म्हणू शकतो तो प्रोसेस जो आहे तो काय आहे, नोट टेकिंगचा. नोट टेकिंग ॲट अ ग्लान्स गिव्ज अ कम्प्लीट व्ह्यू ऑफ अ पॅरेग्राफ ऑर एनी कंटेंट विच कंटेन्स द मेन पॉईंट्स अँड सपोर्टिंग डिटेल ऑफ वॉट इज हर्ड ड्युरिंग द लेक्चर ऑर अ स्पीच. पूर्ण जो पॅरेग्राफ आहे त्याचा ग्लान्स असतो, म्हणजे एक रूपरेखा वी कॅन से, आणि त्याला काही सपोर्टिंग मेन पॉईंट्स आहे, डिटेल्स दिलेले आहे, ते काय आहे जे आपण लिहून काढतो, त्याला काय म्हणतात, त्या प्रोसेसला काय म्हणतात, नोट टेकिंग. टेकिंग नोट्स वाईल रीडिंग फ्रॉम द डिफरंट बुक अँड प्रेझेंट फॉर द डिफरंट पर्पज. आता फॉर एन एक्झाम्पल, आपल्याला एखादा आर्टिकल लिहायचा आहे किंवा आपल्याला एखादा टॉपिक क्रिटिसाइज करायचा आहे किंवा आपल्याला एखादं बुकला क्रिटिसाइज करायचं आहे, तर ऑब्व्हियसली तुम्ही काही पॉईंट्स शोधण्याचा प्रयत्न कराल. तर पॉईंट्स कुठून शोधाल? या पुस्तकातून, त्या पुस्तकातून, किंवा तुम्ही काय पुस्तकं वाचली आहे त्याच्या संदर्भातून तुम्ही एक कन्क्लुजनवर विचार करणार. तर पहिले तुम्ही त्या प्रोसेसला काय करतात, तुम्ही ते पॉईंट टिपण्याचा प्रयत्न करतात. आणि मग ते पॉइंट्स टिपले की मग दॅट ऑन दॅट प्रोसेस ते पुस्तकांना वाचलेलं मग तुम्ही तुमचं रिप्रेझेंट करतात व्हॉट वी वॉन्ट टू क्रिटिसाइज. दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अन नोट टेकिंग प्रोसेस. लेट्स हॅव अन लुक ऑन नोट मेकिंग प्रोसेस. नोट मेकिंग इज अ मोर ॲक्टिव्ह अँड फोकस रायटिंग स्किल. ॲज आय हॅव टोल्ड यू, दिस इज वन ऑफ द टॉपिक विच वी आर हॅविंग फ्रॉम अ रायटिंग स्किल. जनरली दिस क्वेश्चन कम्स इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 2B. वेअर अ कॉन्क्रीट कनेक्शन बिटवीन ऑल रेलिव्हंट कन्सेप्ट्स अँड वर्ड्स इज ड्रॉन टू इन्फ्यूज ऑर कंटेंट ऑल थॉट्स टुगेदर बाय अ मेथड. वेअर अ कॉन्क्रीट कनेक्शन बिटवीन ऑल रेलिव्हंट कन्सेप्ट्स. वॉट एवर थिंग्स हॅज बीन डिस्कस इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पॅसेज, वी हॅव टू पिक अप द मेन, व्हेरी व्हेरी मेन पॉइंट्स अँड वी हॅव टू फोकस ऑन दॅट. And on the basis of that points, we have to make either point, tree diagram or a table in the different form. Yeah. Here we see the similarities between note making and note taking. Both provide the student with a material for easy reference preparation and a study during the examination. Obviously, both has been the same. Note taking as well as note making. Both are useful for taking out the notes. Both aid the students in remembering facts easier as it utilizes both reading and listening senses. Both have the facility of reading, and on the basis of reading, you take out the notes. Both have the same purpose, that is for the students to excel in their studies. Both have the same process. What we can say over here, same process is, it means students try to manage the notes, and on the managing notes they try to jot it down on the notebook, and while written notes they try to focus and they try to find out some purpose regarding that. Both help the students to concentrate better effectively. Yeah, further we will see note taking and the note making. Difference between note taking and note making. Only jotting down points involves no sight interpretation. That is called as a note taking. Here we will see in note making, help student to see each point clearly along with its link or connection with each other. Next point in note taking, that is, very little changes are required while we do note taking. And on the other hand side, note making, easier to change the note made. Next, in note taking, taking points from one source at a time involves the taking of points from the different sources, that is called as a note making. Here we have to do less understanding in note taking. On the other hand side, we can say we have to understand more and we have to perform our activity. On the note taking side, points or the notes are written in the full form. Points given by the source are taken directly. On the other hand side, note making is often in short form. Here, note taking is only gives the early configuration for the whole topic, or on the other side, note making helps the student in capturing its main key. Yeah, as I have told you, when we are doing the tree diagram or any graph, table or whatever it is, on that time we have to take out the key points. Key points, it means the main point. We have to focus on that, and on the basis of that we have to make our diagram. Notes are made from the sources. That is, in the note taking, they are handmade since the time available is limited. As I have told you, note taking is a process in the lecture. On that time, that notes whatever we make, that is an handmade notes, and we have a limited time for that, and on the basis of that we have to jot down points over in our paper. On the other hand side, note making constructed by the learner themselves in handmade or in the computer type form. It means here the learner construct themselves as in some of the points, as I told you the key point. They make the diagram, they make the computerized typed form. It means, as I've told you, we have to make either tree diagram or table or chart or whatever, pie chart, whatever the form it has been asked in the question. In that form, we have to represent our diagram. Here are the some of the styles of note making. First, we have table. Next, chart. In the chart, we have bar chart, pie chart, and the flow charts. Next, we have line graph. Next, diagram. Next, pictograms. Next, maps and the plans. Yeah, my dear students, here are the some of the examples that shows pattern of note making. Here it's one pattern, that is in my notes it is given, or we can say here the same question has been asked. If the question has been asked, just like in prepare a tree diagram of following passage, and if they have given such type of diagram, so what we have to do on that time, we have to take out what is the title about the topic or what the passage want to say, something about the author or what. First, just like things which has been given in the passage, that we have to write in the central idea, and second, we have to write in the central idea point 2. If the same pattern is given, the same you have to make in your answer paper. Here we have another form, that is an table form. Table form, it means one table you will be getting, and the following table you have to write some of the points is given in the paper and some of the points we have to write. Here I'll show you one pattern, that is the pattern is about table form. It is an income tax. Here in the first column they have given the serial number, second term, next is meaning and additional information. Now just see over here, some of the points has been highlighted in the dark bold writing. So it means that we have already given, and if the things which has not given, that we have to write. Just like in the meaning, they have given a financial. Next, I'll be saying additional information, they have given a, it is a legal. So what it is a legal? Tax avoidance, arranging one's financial affairs to reduce tax. Thus, these things we have to write down. Just like see the fourth point. The fourth point, tax assessment they have given. So what is term, what is the meaning of tax assessment? So that we have to write. What is the additional information what we have to write of tax assessment? That we will be writing in that column. My dear students, what we have to focus, if some points has been given, whatever the vacant box are there, there we have to fill our answers. Yeah. Now next form is what? Pie chart. In the pie chart, what we have to do, we have to check out the things which has given over there. Just like the cultivated land over here, index it is given. Not available form cultivation, grazing cultivable, waste cultivable, waste land, fallow land, area under forest. This we have made seeing from where? From the passage. That's it. In this form, when you are making the pie chart, you have to show the index. This is called an actually a pie chart, or we can say it is called as an tree diagram. Next is an bar graph. Bar graph here showing the organ donation pattern in India. Here they have given one of the percentage, and over here I percentage, that is an 86. Obviously, as I've told you, organ donation, kidney pattern, your heart, liver, lungs and intestine. According to the percentage wise, we have to make our bar graph. Next is called as an line graph. Line graph showing the price of motorbikes and corresponding sales. See over here. This is called as an line graph. Most of the students, they have this type of form. They do in the math statistics. So most of them, they know what is an line graph. Yeah, my dear students, now we'll see one example over here which has been solved for you. Here the passage is of Ayurvedic medicine facts. Fundamentals of Ayurvedic medicine. Here we'll see, to understand Ayurvedic treatment, it is essential to have an idea of how the Ayurvedic system regards the human body. Now, in the first line, we have understood what is the passage about. Obviously, it is the passages about the Ayurvedic medicine facts. The basic life force in the body is a prana, which is also found in the element and analogs to the Chinese nation of qi, as in Swami Vivekananda, a yogi and expert, put it. Prana is in the air, but is not the oxygen nor any of the chemical consistent. It is in the food, water, and in the sunlight. Yet, it is not a vitamin heat or a light rays, food, water, air, etc. are only the media through which the prana flows. Obviously, we can just jot down that of the tree diagram which we have to make, that is on the what? Prana. In Ayurveda, there are five basic elements that contains prana: earth, water, fire, and air. And other. Got it over here? So you can make or you can just highlight the point. These elements interact and are further organized in the human body as three primary categories. Again, you can highlight this line, or the basic psychological principle in the body that govern all bodily process known as the dosha. The three doshas are Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. Each individual has a unique blend of the three doshas known as the person's prakriti, which is the reason why the Ayurvedic treatment is always personalized. In Ayurveda, illness is regarded as a state of imbalance in one or more of a person's dosha, and an Ayurvedic physician works to adjust and balance them via a variety of methods. The Vata dosh is associated with the ear and ita, and in the body promotes movement, agility. Vata people are typically thin and light physical, dry skin. Now they have given some of the very important point. This also you have to jot it down, or you can just highlight in the paper only. We are energetic and mentally restless. When Vata is out of balance, there are often nerves problem, hyperactivity, sleeplessness, over back pain, and headache. Now, we have Pitta dosh, is associated with fire and water. In the body, it is responsible for metabolic process and digestion. Pitta characteristics are medium built bodies, fair skin, strong digestion, and the good mental concentration. Pitta imbalances show up as an anger and aggression, and the stress related conditions like gastric ulcers, liver problems, and hypertension. Now, in the last paragraph, they have discussed about the kapha dosh, we can say, is associated with water and earth. People characterized as kapha are generally large or heavy with more oily complexions. They tend to be slow, calm, and peaceful. Kapha disorders manifest emotionally as greed, as possessiveness, and physically and obesity, fatigue, bronchitis, and sinus problems. Yeah, now here, my dear students, now let complete the following diagram that represent prana and its elements. Now, as I've told you, we might have got the passage or tree diagram we might have make about the prana. See over here, in the first prana, basic elements are 4, 5, earth, water, fire, air, and ether. Now see over here, some the things which I have not written, that I have done for you for your knowledge. bodily process divided into three doshas, that also they have given. In which form? Associated with. Next, characteristics and imbalance shows. What are the imbalancing things in the vata, pitta and kapha that has been shown in the three column? This is the salt passage for you, which have seen the which we have seen from that particular paragraph. That is called a tree diagram. Over here we will see the same passage in the table form. Transfer the above mentioned in the information in the form of a table. So what we have to make the table about? Bodily process. In the bodily process, first column we have doshas associated with, characteristics and imbalance causes. So here the things which has been highlighted in the dark bold writing, that is written for you, and the things which has been written in a very small writing, that has been written by me for your knowledge. It means some of the points you will be getting before in the paper, same you have to copy out, and the things which are not there, that we have to write it. As I have told you when we were discussing about the income tax table. Now my dear students, here you have one passage, brainstorming. Read the following passage carefully and complete the activity. Here you have passage, you have to read this passage and you have to make this diagram. Diagram I have made for you, but what you will be doing? You will be writing the further points. Further points, it means lichens, what is the self-medication, medical prescribing diagnosis, over your technological advancement in medicine. One is done for you in the self-medication, one is done for you. And our third point is clever advertising by pharmaceutical companies. Again, one is done for you. Got it over here? This you have to copy out the same in your notebook and you have to fill the rest of the blanks. So here we will be reaching to a topic conclusion, that is, organizing the notes is an essential component of note making or note taking. Student must remember that the notes are for further use. If you fail to make any sense of your notes later, the very purpose of note taking and note making is defeated. So, the use of proper headings and subheading are very important. As I have told you, whatever we are getting the headings, so further we have to write their subheading. Subheading, it means the main points of the passage or the things whatever has been asked in the passage. You must judicially use remember and letters for the subtopics and derived topics. Underlining the using asterisks with the help of you to identify the main points at a glance. Above all, the method and the style of note making and note taking should be in tune with your personal propensity of the ordering things. Got it over here? So this is the conclusion of the note making and note taking. Both the skills are very important, but whatever the skill which we are getting in the paper, that is in the question number 2B, that is our note making skill. Or in the simple, we can say tree diagram. Generally, if I say tree diagram, most of the students have in mind like that they have to make a tree. No, they don't have to make the tree. What they have to do, they have to form some of the format which we have discussed in the video as before. Got it over here? Yeah. My dear students, thanks a lot. Thank you. Hope you have understood the topic note making and note taking. Thank you.